Hey, what's up guys? Today I take a look at the new Bullseye, the Blokhead. Let's get started. The Bullseye is a very popular cooling mod for 3D printers with more than 1 million downloads on Thingiverse. David Petzl just released a new version of its Bullseye, the Blokhead. In today's video, I installed the Blokhead on my Ender 3 Pro and carry out some testing. In order to complete the assembly, you will need the 3D printed base for your 3D printers, the 3D printed blockhead fan duct, a 24 volts radial 50-15 fan. This fan costs less than 10 euro or 10 US dollar on Amazon. The screws that come with your printer after disassembling the stock fan. 4 M3 nuts. 2 M3x12mm screws. 1 M4 nut. 1 M4 by 30mm screw. Detach a hot end cover by removing the 2 M3 screws. Detach a layer fan on the right side of the hot end cover. Do not lose any screw, we need them later to assemble the blockhead. Detach the fan inside the hot end cover. Insert 4 entry nuts into the base. Attach the base to the printer with 2 entry screws. Attach the fan to the base with 3 entry screws. Slide the duct into the base and secure it with 2 M3x12mm screws. Insert the fan into the duct and secure it with 1 M4 screw and 1 M4 nut. Connect the fan wires, positive is yellow and negative is blue. Adjust the duct 8. The ideal position is when the duct openings are just below the insulation block as shown on the image. Now let's compare the airflow and the noise between the Ender 3 Pro stock cooling on the blockhead. Not surprising, when using the Ender 3 Pro stock cooling fan, the airflow is mostly directed on the right side of the nozzle. With the blockhead, the airflow is significantly increased and is directed directly underneath the nozzle. By reducing the fan speed to 75%, we can still get a very good airflow but significantly reduce the noise level. In order to assess as objectively as possible the influence of the cooling on the print quality, I use the cooling fan torture test from TeachingTech available on Thingiverse. To get started, I first printed the test with the fan off. The result is much better than I expected, but is of course far from perfect. The most obvious issue is at the top of the central spire. Without fan, the previous layer has no time to cool down before the printer comes back to print the next layer. This clearly impacts negatively the accuracy of the print. As expected, the bridge and the overhang's quality is not very good neither. Clearly, a cooling fan is required when printing in the air, and when the filament has not enough time to cool down naturally between two consecutive layers. Next, I printed the torture test with the stock cooling of the Ender 3 Pro. With the stock cooling, the print quality is not perfect, but is surprisingly good. The stock cooling works fine, and you may not need a better cooling, unless you really want to improve bridges and overhangs. Finally, I printed the torture test with the Blokhead. The print quality is better everywhere. The central spire is much better defined. The bridge and the overhangs look better. I'll let you make your own judgment. When we compare the three prints side by side, the difference of quality becomes more obvious. As we move from the no-fan case on the left, to the stock cooling of the Ender 3 in the middle, and to the Blokhead on the right. Time for a conclusion. For most prints, the stock cooler is good enough, and you may not need a better cooling. The Blokhead provides several advantages with respect to the Ender 3 Pro stock cooling. It improves the overall print quality. It looks beautiful, although this is subjective, of course. It improves the visibility on the nozzle, which is especially important when printing the first layer or leveling the bed. It is easy and quick to print and does not require any support. It is inexpensive, just required to buy a fan for less than 10 euro or 10 US dollars. The only drawback of the Blokhead is the noise of the fan at full speed. The noise can be significantly reduced by operating the fan at 50% or even 75%. This will provide a better cooling than the stock fan at a similar noise level. That's it for me today. I hope you enjoyed this video and learned something useful today.
Thank you so much for watching. See you soon.